एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल लाइफ साइंस विद निवेदिता। सो दिस कार्बोहाइड्रेट मेटाबॉलिज्म लेक्चर वीडियो सीरीज पार्ट 3। सो इन द पार्ट 1 वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन एंड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, एंड इन द पार्ट 2 वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट डाइजेशन एंड अब्सॉर्प्शन ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मेटाबॉलिज्म एंड ऑल्सो सेलुलर रेस्पिरेशन। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज मेटाबॉलिज्म? व्हाई आवर बॉडी नीड्स मेटाबॉलिज्म? बिकॉज टू परफॉर्म एनी फंक्शन वी and also our body organs need energy, right? So for that energy, our body has to be metabolized. So in this video, we are discussed about the metabolism. So before going to the metabolism, we need some basic concept about this metabolism process. So first of all, we intake food, right? That is carbohydrate contained food. So first of all, what is carbohydrate? It is one of biomolecule. Like we are, the food which we have intake will contain biomolecules like carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, right? So in that, carbohydrate is also one of biomolecules. So what are the foods? For example, oats, when come to the fruits, that is orange, banana, and also wheat, jowar, potato. Okay, so all these food will contain carbohydrates. Okay, so all these are very rich in carbohydrates. So we intake these foods through diet, right? So, and also major source, that is starch. So where starch is present? In rice. So daily we intake rice, right? So rice is rich of starch. So starch is carbohydrate, and that is polysaccharide, right? Starch is a polysaccharide. So through diet, we intake the starch that has to be digested and absorbed. So initially what happened? We intake the starch. For example, we intake the rice. So rice will contain starch. So in the mouth, digestion will be takes place, that is small amount of digestion. Then it is enters the small intestine. At last it is enter, after the mouth it enters stomach. So after the stomach it enters small intestine, right? So in the small intestine what happened? The digestion will be ended. So after digestion ended, it has to be undergo absorption, right? So why it has to be absorbed? Because to perform metabolic process. Why? Because metabolism will take place inside the cell. Okay. So absorption has to be takes place because the glucose. After the digestion, what happened? The starch polysaccharide, that is converted into monosaccharide, right? So what is monosaccharide unit? That is glucose, right? So this glucose has to be enter inside the cell. Okay. This monosaccharide glucose has to enter inside the cell to perform metabolic process. So for entry of the glucose, some glucose transporters are there. Okay, through that transporters, glucose will enter inside the cell. So why? What is the need of glucose entry of cells means? Because to perform any function, for example, I am writing, I am talking, I am whatever function I do, for that I need energy, right? So for that energy, metabolism has to be takes place. And not only my work, even though our body organs, that is brain and also heart, kidney, so all organs certain they will undergo some special functions. For example, when take the heart, it will pumping the blood, right? So for pumping the blood, it needs some sort of energy. For that energy, metabolism has to be takes place. Okay, so this is the major introduction of metabolism. So now move on to the concept. Okay, so see here, metabolism means what? When come to the definition, it is all chemical and energy transformation that occur in the body. Okay, it is energy transformation and also chemical reaction which is occur in our body. So in this metabolism, two types, that is anabolism and also catabolism. And in this metabolism, the major functions involved is in enzymes, because this is the main thing which is helpful for the conversion. Okay, so in the metabolism, two types, anabolism and also catabolism. So first of all, what is anabolism? So it is the formation of large organic molecules with uptake of energy. So here what happened? From the small molecules, it will produce large molecules. Okay, so in anabolism process what happened? It takes energy. So what is the energy? ATP is called as energy currency, right? So for the anabolic process, it requires energy to form complex molecule. Okay, this is simple molecule. To conversion of complex molecule, it requires energy, that is ATP. Okay, so anabolic reaction are endergonic. Endergonic is nothing but they consume more energy rather than produce. Okay, because for the metabolism process, energy has to be released, right? But in anabolism, what happens? Rather than producing energy, it will utilize for the functioning. Okay, see here, it is called as endergonic. Why? Because they consume more energy rather than produce. Okay, so the next type is catabolism. So catabolism means what? Breakdown. Anabolism means producing new complex molecule. But catabolism means what happened? This is complex molecule. Okay, this complex molecule. So here what happened? This complex molecule has to be breakdown into smaller molecules. So after breakdown, what happened? Here ATP is released. Okay, in the catabolism, ATP is not utilized. ATP will be released. Okay, so here, see here. This catabolism is breakdown of large organic molecules with release of energy. Here what happened? Energy released, not utilized. Okay, so for maintaining the body function, why energy has to be released? For the maintaining of body functions, energy will be released. Okay, so now move on to the difference. So see here, this is catabolism and also this is anabolism. So catabolism is the set of metabolic pathways that breaks down molecules into smaller units. Okay, as I already mentioned, from the complex molecules here, it will produce smaller units and also produce some sort of energy, that is in the form of ATP, NADH, whatever. Okay, so here what happened? To release energy and are used in other anabolic reactions. So this energy which is released from the catabolic process, right? So this is utilized from the anabolic process for performing another function. So this is about catabolism. When come to the anabolism, here what happened? From the smaller units, it will form complex molecule. Here energy will be utilized. Here not producing. Okay. So anabolism is the set of metabolic pathways that construct molecules from smaller units. So these reactions require energy, called as endergonic. Okay, so endergonic means what? It will require energy for production of complex molecule. So see here, this is bigger molecule. So after, in the catabolism process, what happened? It will break down into smaller molecules and energy will be released. But in anabolism, what happened? The smaller molecules is converted into these complex molecules to form the bond, that is to form the complex molecules. It requires energy. Okay, so this is the major difference between catabolism and anabolism. So why I explain these two means, metabolism is nothing but in this metabolism process, both anabolism also takes place some cases and also catabolism also takes place. Sometimes energy released, sometimes energy utilized. Okay, so that's why this is the two major types of metabolism. Okay, so now see here. This is chemical energy, that is carbohydrates, fats, and other biomolecules. So by intaking, see ATP is what? ATP is energy currency. Sorry. So see here, this is ATP, right? So ATP is called as energy currency, means energy. So body's energy currency is ATP. Okay. So means how it is ATP is produced? By the metabolism process, and also not only utilizing some part of the food also excreted from our body, that is carbon dioxide, water, that is, this will resembles outside, that is excreted. Okay, and also some sort of heat also excreted from our body. Okay, so what are the food we intake? Not all things are absorbed. Some are absorbed for the metabolic process, and some sort of things are excreted, that is removed from our body. Okay, so next thing. So as I already mentioned, through diet, we intake glucose, that is in the food, right? So that food, after the digestion, after the absorption, enter inside the cell, right? So after enter inside the cell, metabolism has to be takes place. So see here, this is glucose, which is containing in the food. That glucose, after entering inside the cell, the first metabolic process takes place is glycolysis. Okay, this is the first metabolic process which is takes place in the carbohydrate metabolism. Okay, so in carbohydrate metabolism, after entering the glucose, a glucose enter inside the cell, right? For example, this is cell. So inside the cell, glucose will enter. Okay, by the absorption, glucose is enter. So inside the cell, energy has to be released, right? So for that release that energy, some process, some pathway, some cycles has to be run. So the first pathway, the first process is glycolysis. Okay, so see here, glycolysis will happen. So after glycolysis, it will produce pyruvate. The pyruvate is the end product of glycolysis. So after pyruvate, this pyruvate is enter inside the Krebs cycle, and the means the products which is produced from the glycolysis and also Krebs cycle will enter into the electron transport chain. At last, it will produce ATP. ATP is the energy currency, right? To perform any function, our body needs ATP. So like this, in this manner, our body will produce ATP. Okay. So see here, as I already mentioned, after entering of the glucose, the first process which is takes place is glycolysis, right? So see here, this is glucose. And one more thing, this glycolysis is takes place in the cytosol. Okay, this is mitochondria. But inside the mitochondria, rest of two reactions are there, right? That is Krebs cycle and also electron transport chain will be takes place in the mitochondria, but in cytosol, glycolysis will be takes place. So in the carbohydrate metabolism, these are the three major pathways, that is glycolysis, Krebs cycle, and also electron transport chain. Okay, to producing ATP, these three cycles has to be run. Okay, the first path, this is pathway, and these two are, this is chain like reaction, and this is cycle. So we discussed each one in next further videos. Okay, so here this is some introduction. Okay, so here what happened, glycolysis takes place in cytosol, right? So here glucose is converted into pyruvate, and in between these things, many reactions takes place. We discussed in the glycolysis part. Okay, so when pyruvate will converted, this pyruvate is enter inside the mitochondria, because Krebs cycle is takes place in mitochondria, not in cytosol. Okay, so pyruvate will enter inside the mitochondria. So after, with the form of acetyl-CoA enzyme, okay, this pyruvate is not directly enter into the mitochondria. It has to be converted into acetyl-CoA. So that acetyl-CoA will enter inside the mitochondria and perform citric acid cycle. Krebs cycle is also called as citric acid cycle. Okay, so here also some sort of ATP released. Here also some sort of ATP released. So at last, the products which is produced from the glycolysis and also Krebs cycle will enter into the electron transport chain. Okay, in electron transport chain, this is the ending process of carbohydrate metabolism. So here at last, some sort of ATP will be released. So this ATP will utilize for the body functions and also some metabolic functions and some organelle like heart, kidney, brain, I mentioned, right? So for that functions, this ATP will be utilized. Okay. So now cellular respiration. So first of all, cellular respiration means what? We do respire, right? So we taken oxygen and release carbon dioxide. This is respiration process. In the same way, our cells also do respiration. Okay, so in that respiration, this metabolic process will be takes place. Okay, so in the respiration, in the cellular respiration, two types, that is aerobic and also anaerobic. The name itself says aerobic means in the presence of oxygen, anaerobic means in the absence of oxygen. Okay, so the glucose enter inside the cell, glycolysis takes place. So after glycolysis, what happened? That is Krebs cycle takes place, that is in mitochondria, glycolysis in cytosol. So after the Krebs cycle, what happened? ETC will be takes place in mitochondria and certain amount of ATP will be released. This is about aerobic. Okay, that is in the presence of oxygen, and in absence of oxygen also some pathway will be occurring. That is, see here, this is after the glycolysis, some ATP will be produced, right? So in that ATP, some of the ATP will enter into the anaerobic respiration. Okay, that is in the absence of oxygen, that is lactic acid fermentation and also alcohol fermentation. Okay, so by to perform these two cycles, that is perform in the anaerobic process, that is in the absence of oxygen. Okay, so this is about introduction about cellular respiration. So now move on to the next thing. So see here, this is the overview of aerobic respiration, because to produce ATP, aerobic respiration has to be taken. That is, the first stage is which one? Glycolysis. So after glycolysis, the acetyl-CoA has to be formed, because the end product of glycolysis is pyruvate. That pyruvate has to be converted into acetyl-CoA. Then these acetyl-CoA is enter inside the mitochondria and perform citric acid cycle, that is Krebs cycle. Okay, so see here, glucose. So inside the cell, it is occur, that is in cytosol. So in cytosol, it is produced pyruvate. So after pyruvate oxidation, that is formation of acetyl-CoA. So that acetyl-CoA is enter inside the TCA cycle, that is in the mitochondria. So after here, what happened? At last, it is enter in the ETC, that is electron transport chain. Okay, so after this, some sort of ATP will be released. This ATP is utilized for the functioning. Okay, so this is overview of metabolism and also cellular respiration. Okay, so in the next video, we are taken the each pathway, that is glycolysis, TCA, citric acid cycle and all. So we discussed. So this is about today's video. So if any kind of doubts, any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. I definitely do the answer. Okay. So hope you people got some information through this video. If you like this video, hit the like button and share maximum with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, stay safe, stay healthy.